Welcome back to Rimjob 69 Seizure. It has been a long time, so long in fact that the toxicity of the Rainbow Six Siege community's Trojan horsed itself into the game and is now running around like Sandy Hook survivors whenever they hear popcorn popping and freak the fuck out. Oh, two pistol kills. Me at school be like...
Okay, I have to go now.
I figured I might as well give a rundown of the nightmare fluid cocktail called Containment, because this game mode can bounce between holy fuck, this is terrifyingly fun, and game bad, big mad, so often that I think I would rather have my childhood get fucked by the barrel of an ISIS AK.
Donald Duck in Afghanistan.
Can you say quit riding your camel around, Khabib, in a Donald Duck accent?
Not that I don't want to, I actually don't fucking know how to say anything besides fuck.
Fucking ching chong bitches. Fuck the other two.
Can you say Allahu Akbar in a Donald Duck voice? This is your first time playing the game, right?
One. Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Kroot and the Bubonic Plague, a romance. She's just a purple polka dot taking up space on a Rooney, Jaeger-Cade Ward, and Mirror's buddy and preparing to Mayflower-style slaughter anything that works. He's just a fucking tree. Yeah, that's it. The stick boy has no other defining traits. Together, they can do anything. Brain dead boots contain the rant. You're going to shint your pants. All the demons, sleep paralysis instead of dreaming, don't you know? This cancer is here to stay for 18 days. A Rooney, Jaeger, and Cade, Warden, and Mira became human embodiments of the plague. Their DNA got fucked by Groot's morning wood. Kinda gay. IQ 0, Ace MRU, and Blackbeard keep on getting slaughtered. Slaughtered by these genetic abominations. Destroy the nests or shoot the trees, they'll fill you full of lead and full of holes like Sarge out there in the trees. I think we need a Vietnamese operator. His name can be Con Con. Imagine a 3-speed with the ability to tunnel anywhere on the map.
Definitely.
His ability should be the ability to cook minute rice in 58 seconds, though.
And it just heals everybody instantly.
He just gives everybody the camouflage of a rice field. I want an operator that just installs speakers around the map to play Welcome to the Jungle.
In the jungle, welcome to the jungle.
Yo, boys, you want recoil control? I got you. Where are we shooting? Welcome to the rice field, motherfuckers. Hell yeah, brother. I love that in Vietnam you can just do that to the trees and you'll probably get like 5 or 6. Car salesman slaps bush. This bad baby can fit literally all of Vietnam in it. Speaking of Vietnam flashbacks, I recently tried out the game Squad, a milsim made of senile veterans desperately trying to hold on to their battle-scarred sanity by refusing to leave the line of duty, and holy fuck, I thought Siege was toxic. I said, I would hate to play Uno with Dora, she would take all the green cards. Dead silent. And I was like, hey guys, remember when Michael Phelps got in all that trouble for getting caught smoking weed? So which is more embarrassing to you guys? The fact that your hero got in trouble for smoking weed, or the fact that you guys looked up to a swimmer in the first place? Oh, you mean that shit that we do naturally? It's incredible. And I got so much hate. I tried to bring it back by saying, well, I mean, I shouldn't talk. I'm Canadian. We have Terry Fox, who ran across the country, made it literally like maybe a fifth of the way there, got cancer and died, which says a lot about Canada, but you know, dead silence.
Yeah.
And then somebody just said, shut the fuck up. Michael Phelps accomplished more than your country will ever. Stay in your lane, snow Mexican. I mean, I was just joking with him, like, yeah, no, don't worry about it. I gotta take a break. You're gonna snort some maple syrup off my beaver pelt. Just wake me when the playoffs start. No one's gonna fuck with me. I have the lead vest of America draped around my fat ass. I'm just upset that everyone there was getting fucking Vietnam PTSD and couldn't laugh at my goddamn jokes. But anyways, let's get back to the new school shooter game. That came out wrong. Let's break it down. Depending on your team's skill and whether you blew a leprechaun's lucky chode for extra luck this morning, the main course of this miscarriage of a meal is cyberbullying. From the toxicity of the players to the ridiculousness of the bullshit mechanics in the game, because they make as much sense as Batman going to the hospital with 9k cash to buy back his dead parents for redeployment, convinced that they just lost their gulag. That being said, when has Siege ever made much sense?
I'm just gonna put you, Mike, inside my bungo drum.
Regardless, this stupid game mode brought out the dumbass in me for one more Siege shitpost, so I swam through the toxicity, the flatlining game mechanics, and the fact that I don't enjoy shoveling the shit down my throat anymore, so please enjoy me doing that to you fuckers with what I call funny moments.
Why don't the attackers just carry a fucking crowbar on them? You know how easy it would be to open up a barricade?
But I guess carrying a crowbar around as like the special ops agent would be sort of be like bringing cocaine to the airport so you can pet the dogs. I caught two people with pokeballs. Capitan, I choose you. Yous get dragged by Sean the leg because of your skin color. If somebody commits suicide, you think their twin hears,
"Stay alert, your teammate just got their ass kicked."
That's not right.
Do you know what an artist and a sniper have in common?
Details.
The only difference are the sticks. Mine and higher.
The difference is the money. I am employed.
No. Oh, you're done. That's a person. Shoot him in the head. You got this. Come on. No.
Wait, wait, wait. How did he kill Yenker? I don't understand.
When I was a boy, we had a dog. He started pissing everywhere, so we had to put him down. And even in his final moments, he was more spatially aware than you were that entire round.
Half of my heart is in Japan.
Hey! My heart has a knife to it. I come at the Pokemon.
Amerakunana.
You take me back to Hiroshima, Unana.
Boom!
And now we're safe in Nagasaki, Nagasaki, Unana.
Boom!
My DNA is ruined. My DNA is ruined. Amerakunana.
I guess if you're an orphan, every selfie is a family photo, huh?
Oh, fuck.
Saturday the 4th. Is that a weekend or?
Say that again or... slowly.
Not Saturday.
I bet you get all the girls in the special ed class, dog.
What do you call Mountain Dew at a party? Fondo.
I wanna hang you.
Hang with me?
Oh, won't you hang with me? Cause I'm depressed, you see. This life is not worth living. So won't you hang with me?
If Sam Smith was black and lived in the 1800s.
If Sam Smith lived in the 1800s, period. Man is gay. Oh, you sent me an invite. Look at this f***. You sent me an invite. What did I do?
You Sam Smith? Oh.
Sam Smith be like. Sam Smith in the 1800s be like.
Before the video ends, thank you fuckers so much for 5k subs, 50k on TikTok, and 300 kings in Discord. You guys are insane, and for my 5k special, I've decided to double down and do three highly requested things. Number one, the boot reveal. I'm going to be revealing and reviewing a pair of boots in the most brain-dead way possible. Up next, the durability test. We're going to be testing the shell of this boot against this shotgun 12-gauge slug from point blank, but remember, always make sure the barrel is clear before you fire so you don't damage the gun. You can do this by looking straight down the rabbit hole just to... I'm also going to be designing custom decals for the boots, and you guys can request whatever you want. My logo, your favorite boots quote, Johnnyson's cock and balls cropped into a swastika, anything you choose. Leave your submissions in the comments below, and I'll hold a vote on my Twitter at BootsBraindead. So go follow that shit if you want to say, and to see what other dumb shit I smile at in the dead of night. Anime characters are able to gain 15 years of training with just the power of friendship. I must be losing my fights against 6th graders because I have no friends. Number 2, the Braindead album. Many people have asked me to put some songs on Spotify or Apple Music, so that's exactly what I'm going to try to do. I can't wait to increase the amount of platforms I can get blocked and banned on. Number 3, the Braindead Boots Rap Battles. The kings of my Discord know that I used to do Monday Night Rap Battles, where I would mop the floor with their sorry asses, and I stopped it to bring it back with the force of 1,000 elephant corpses. I will be hosting a rap battle tournament for the special, and if you want to participate or watch us look like dumbasses to music, then join the Discord, link in below. Once again, thank you for all your support. You guys mean the world to me, and I'm glad that I can entertain you. On that note, I'm out. Of course I'm being tracked again.